Hello and welcome to Pirate News. I'm Madelyn Woodson.
And I'm Bob Towey. Today we'll bring you the latest news in campus events, Seton Hall sports, and your five-day weather forecast.
Campus Ministry will be hosting their annual Christmas party tonight at 8 p.m. in McNulty Hall. Food and refreshments will be served. Bring your Christmas cheer. Contact Allison Santalago for more information.
The College of Arts and Sciences will offer a special one-credit symposium on Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. The class will take place from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. on MLK Day, Monday, January 21st in Bethany Hall, and it's open to all Seton Hall students and alumni as well as members of the community. For Seton Hall undergrads, the class comes at no extra cost as long as you're enrolled in 17 credits or fewer during the spring semester. For more information, contact the director of Seton Hall's MLK Leadership Program and the teacher of the symposium, Reverend Forrest Pritchett, at forrest.pritchett@shu.edu.
Next Tuesday, December 11th, there will be a wrapping extravaganza as part of a coordination between the Division of Volunteer Efforts and Seton Hall's 12 Acts of Kindness. If you are interested in volunteering, stop by the Dove office or contact Michelle Peterson for more information. The event will take place at 11 a.m. in the Campus Ministry Lounge in Boland Hall.
Poetry in the Round hosts author Jenny Offal today at 6 p.m. in the Faculty Lounge of the University Center. Offal is a fiction writer, recipient of a Guggenheim Fellowship, and next year's writer-in-residence at Vassar College, and she'll be reading excerpts from her work at the event. For more information, contact Kara Blue Adams at kara.adams@shu.edu.
And now we'll head over to Andrew Sciancalepore with your Seton Hall sports update. Andrew?
Thanks, Madelyn. Hello, Pirate fans. This is Andrew Sciancalepore with your Seton Hall sports update. In men's basketball, the Pirates were able to secure a comfortable 77-57 win versus the struggling New Hampshire Wildcats. With limited roster availability, head coach Kevin Miller was able to get the most out of Sandro Mamukelashvili, who recorded his first double-double of the season with 14 points and 11 rebounds, while point guard Quincy McKnight added 18 points himself, while guard Miles Powell chipped in with 10 points as well. This victory was Seton Hall's 1,500th program win and head coach Willard's 200th career victory. The Pirates now go on to their biggest test of the season with the headline matchup versus the 9th-ranked Kentucky Wildcats at Madison Square Garden this Saturday. This upcoming stretch of games will certainly be a tough challenge for the Pirates once again in this young 2018-19 season. On the topic of tough challenges, the women's basketball team will surely have its own test this Saturday as well, with a matchup versus the number one team in the nation, the UConn Huskies in Hartford, Connecticut. The Pirates will look to their experience in guards Nicole Jimenez and Victoria Cardesi, and star forward Shadeen Samuels to lead this upcoming Seton Hall team into battle in one of the best programs in the nation. And finally, senior Dakota Williams set a meet record this past weekend at the Patriot Invitational at George Mason University by posting a 44.75 in the 100 feet as the Seton Hall men's and swimming and diving team finished 4th out of 8 teams in the entire Invitational. Well, that wraps it up for your Seton Hall sports update. Once again, I'm Andrew Sciancalepore, and now back to Madelyn and Bob with more news you need to know.
Thank you, Andrew. The Walsh Gallery received a $10,000 grant from the Robert Lehman Foundation in support of the Strange Attractors exhibition that will feature there next year. The exhibit explores the intersection of art and science and will appear in the gallery from January through March of 2019.
The Student Activities Board will be bringing the Winter Fun indoors this Friday, December 7th. An ice rink will make an appearance in the main lounge in the University Center from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. There will also be a screening of the famed Christmas movie, The Polar Express. Lace up those skates and hit the ice with some friends. Contact Allison Santalago for more information. Now we'll head over to Daniel Baluch with your five-day weather forecast. Daniel?
Thank you, Madelyn. Hello, Pirates. My name is Daniel Baluch, and this is your five-day weather forecast for the South Orange area. Today, we will have partly cloudy skies with a high of 39 degrees and a low of 29 degrees. On Friday, we will have clear sunny skies with a high of 37 degrees and a low of 23 degrees. Now over here on Saturday, we will have partly cloudy skies with a high of 35 degrees and a low of 24 degrees. On Sunday, we have partly cloudy skies with a high of 36 degrees and a low of 25 degrees. And finally, on Monday, there will be partly cloudy skies with a high of 38 degrees and a low of 26 degrees. That's all, folks. Best of luck with your finals. And now back to Bob and Madelyn with more of the news you need to know.
Thanks, Daniel. Seton Hall will host free lessons in the Korean language on Friday in Fahey Hall, room 203B. The class, hosted by native Korean speaker Yang Kim, is offered through the Korean Language Club and open to anyone interested in the Korean culture. For more information, contact Michael Stone of the Language Resource Center at michael.stone@shu.edu.
Is the stress of final season getting to you? Take a break on reading day with Makerspace as they take over Space 154 to bring you the latest in technological therapy. Meditate in 3D using the Oculus Rift or use the Relax VR app to pair a VR headset for maximum immersion. You can also race spherobots or try your luck at an augmented reality obstacle course. The event will run from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m.
This concludes our broadcast of Pirate News. I'm Bob Towey.
And I'm Madelyn Woodson. Thanks for watching and have a great day.